Hey guys, and it's time to enter the twist zone. Samsung is onto some stuff which we did not expect at all. A special surprise indeed. Wall Street Journal just today broke this huge news that Samsung's special edition Galaxy S10 5G version will rock 6 cameras and will have a 6.7 inch display. Let that sink in for a second. 6.7 inch display and 6 cameras. Wall Street Journal confirms that Samsung has 3 models coming worldwide, which we already know, the S10 Lite, the Galaxy S10 and the S10 Plus, and then a 4th 5G version of the Galaxy S10, but we didn't know that the 5G Galaxy S10 will be on steroids. They said it will have a 6.7 inch display and total of 6 cameras, 4 on the back and 2 on the front. I'm lost for words, guys. This is insane. This 5G monster is expected to launch during the springtime, and it's set to launch first in Korea, where there will be 5G network availability. So why do they have to go all the way to 6.7 inch display? Well, I believe it's going to be a gaming phone with 5G capability. 5G requires better heat management, so this is why I think it's going to be a big phone with better cooling system. And they don't want to just make a 5G phone, but they want to make something really special. Combined with 5G, you get 6 cameras, 4 on the back and 2 on the front. It is indeed a monster Samsung Galaxy S10 variant. The Wall Street Journal further says that the 4 cameras promise richer photos and better spatial perception. This last part is interesting, and a report from Korea has revealed what that means. So you'll see a wide angle lens, a super wide angle lens, an optical zoom lens, which is similar to a normal S10 Plus, and then the 4th time of flight sensor. You might be thinking, what is flight sensor? Well, it's a 3D sensor that can recognize objects or a person from a considerable distance. It will help in depth sensing, enhanced AR and VR experience with real-time 3D implementation, and most of all, it will be used as a facial scanner. It can do facial recognition. The report says that the time of flight sensor camera will be implemented on the back and the front of the Galaxy S10 5G variant. Yes, it's going to be specific to the monster steroid S10 version, and it's said to bring a lot to the table. Apple is also expected to bring the ToF sensor to the 2019 iPhones for enhanced AR and VR experience, so next year could be the year of time of flight sensors. The report further says that the 5G Galaxy S10 will be unveiled at an event in February, but its release depends on the 5G support from carriers. Verizon, AT&T, and T-Mobile are working on 5G support, and other tech companies, including OnePlus, Xiaomi, and Motorola, are also working on their 5G phones. So there's a huge, huge chance that this phone will most likely come to US market as well. There's also a mention of reverse charging, which we first saw on the Huawei Mate 20 Pro. So this 5G Galaxy S10 Plus can offer charging to other phones. Since it's such a big phone, it's gonna have a super big battery as well. Along with the Samsung Galaxy S10, Samsung will for sure unveil their first ever foldable phone next year in 2019. This is a huge surprise indeed. I always thought that the Galaxy S10 5G variant will just offer 5G. I mean, there has to be some major differences, and this is what is coming with a 6.7 inch display with 6 cameras. Total monster. Also, we have a benchmark for the Snapdragon 8150 processor that reveals that it's the best with the AI. It has the most AI benchmark score compared to any of the chipsets of today. It's a 7-nanometer chip built on Samsung's latest technology, so performance should be amazing. I expect it to be on par with the Exynos 9820. Now on to the Infinity O. This is a huge topic that we'll be discussing on the channel for the past few weeks. We have our first visual leak of the panel itself that shows a hole in the center. This is said to be the panel for the Samsung Galaxy A8s, the first phone which is coming with the Infinity O display in the start of 2019, even before the Galaxy S10. The hole is even smaller than a teardrop notch, and it's gonna be powered by a Snapdragon 660 chipset. It's not gonna be a flagship level phone, although it will use the flagship level design. On the back, we can expect triple cameras, and its release date, it could be specific to China, at least in the start. So this leak kind of shows what you can expect on the Samsung Galaxy S10. The hole can actually be on the left of the display. Also, Samsung's vice president Suk Chung recently said that the next iteration of Bixby is coming with the foldable phone, with full third-party developer support to create awesome features for the Bixby. If it's coming with a foldable phone, then it's safe to assume that this Bixby 3.0 will most likely come with Galaxy S10 family as well. Next year, Samsung is going all the way in with the best they can offer. According to an insider, he said that there's a lot of pressure on DJ Ko, the CEO of Samsung smartphone business. Samsung was leading in India, but now they are behind Xiaomi. And in China, they are behind at least 5 of the local manufacturers. But Samsung hopes to turn everything around with the Samsung Galaxy S10. All of this depends on the success of the Galaxy S10. It has to succeed, otherwise the DJ Ko, the CEO of Samsung smartphone business, can lose his job. Anyways, with all the leaks that are happening right now, I can definitely expect Samsung to be at the number one again, because this stuff is pretty damn amazing. That's all on the latest Samsung news. The special surprise is the Monster 5G Galaxy S10 model with 6 cameras, ToF sensor is coming. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.